Welcome to Mobycon Academy. I'm Narayan Donaldson. I work with Mobycon on street design in North America. And today we're going to talk about some key characteristics of Dutch traffic signal design. So some traffic signals are fixed time, which means that they have a pre-programmed sequence of green, yellow, and red that simply repeats throughout the day. But most traffic signals actually have some form of detection, which allows them to detect road users, such as pedestrians and vehicles, including bicycles. That may be buttons for pedestrians and bicycles. There could be loop detectors, which are magnetic detectors in the road, often used for bicycles and other vehicles. There can be cameras, could be used for any type of vehicle, and various other technologies used to detect the presence or position of people. And yes, the pedestrian call buttons and bicycle buttons do work in most cases. So the pedestrian button, the main function of it is to call the phase. During the following cycle, the pedestrian phase will occur. So if nobody presses the button, it could get skipped to save time in the cycle. For vehicles, in addition to calling the phase to occur in the next signal cycle, it can also extend the green phase. So for example, if there are a lot of cars approaching, and there continue to be cars approaching based on the detectors, the green phase will be held green for longer. So buses often use a GPS-based system, which allows them to communicate via the central control system of the traffic signals, as well as a transit control center, to the traffic signal. And via GPS, that position is transmitted to the traffic signal in order to provide priority to the bus or tram. So to provide an example of how things work in practice, I've chosen a very typical Dutch intersection, which is the intersection of Schumacherstraat and Zuidplantsoen in Delft. The first thing to consider when looking at Dutch traffic signal design is that there generally actually aren't as many traffic signals in the Netherlands as there are in North America, looking at a given type of road design. So this is largely because the network design in the Netherlands is often focused towards traffic calming, which can avoid the need for traffic signals in the first place, and instead can allow the use of other solutions such as roundabouts and pedestrian crossings such as zebra crossings. But where traffic signals do exist, they have two key differences from the way they operate in North America. First of all, there are far more fully protected signal phases, which means that when someone has a green light, there is no other conflicting direction which also has a green light. In North America, it's quite common that when you're turning left, you have to wait for a gap in traffic. Whereas in the Netherlands, traffic turning left would typically have a dedicated period in the cycle during which no other traffic is allowed to cross their path. The other main difference is that the signals tend to be more responsive to real-time detection. So when something is detected or someone is detected, the signals have a better ability to actually provide a green to them based on their knowledge, the signal's knowledge of what other vehicles or people are present at the intersection. So that means that hopefully there's less chance of you waiting at a red light when there's actually nobody crossing your path. So first let's take a look at an example of fully protected signal phasing. What you see now is that the signal is sitting in green for the bicycle signal. And as soon as a traffic signal detects a vehicle approaching which wants to turn right across the bicycle path, the bicycle path gets a yellow light and the red light, then the right turning signal gets a green light. Once the vehicle has entered the intersection, it no longer needs a green light, so that light can change to yellow and then back to red, and the bicycle path signal can go back to green. But the problem with having so many different fully protected signal phases is that it can often increase the length of the cycle because there are more signal phases to cycle through during the cycle. To manage this, Dutch signals use a lot of vehicle actuation, which means that they respond quite closely to what is detected in real time. In order to keep signal phases short, the Netherlands typically uses multiple detectors per lane. So the one closest to the stop line typically is used to make sure that the signal knows when there's someone waiting for the traffic signal. The next longer loop will typically be used to determine when the traffic signal queue has cleared, so there's not a line of cars there waiting. And the furthest detector will typically be used to request the signal because it's the furthest away, so you have the first information that there's a vehicle approaching, and also to help extend the light when vehicles are traveling at higher speeds. So here's an example at the intersection where you can see that the light starts changing to yellow for bicycles before the vehicle approaching on the side street has already reached the stop line. And this is possible thanks to the detectors, which are well in advance of the intersection. In this example, you can see that the light changes to yellow very promptly after the last vehicle in the queue crosses the stop line. Another notable characteristic of Dutch traffic signals is the level of flexibility they have in phase control, which means that there's a pretty much unlimited flexibility for different phases to be combined depending on the road users which are detected in real time. This can be quite advantageous compared to simply averaging the road users which are expected to be at the intersection during a particular time of day. In this example, you can see that this traffic traveling straight through in one direction gets a green light slightly earlier than traffic traveling straight in the opposite direction, simply because there happened to be less time needed on that side based on the direction that the pedestrian was crossing. Another common characteristic of Dutch traffic signals is that they use multi-stage crossings. So this means that a pedestrian crossing actually consists of two separate signalized phases, which are typically coordinated so that pedestrians don't have to stop in the median. The main benefit of doing it this way is that it allows more flexibility in the signal timing. So for example, when the pedestrian has already completed crossing one half of the intersection, that half of the intersection is now free for other movements to get a green light, which reduces delay for other movements and can help reduce the cycle length overall, which comes back around to help pedestrians. Another method that's used commonly in the Netherlands to keep signals cycling as quickly as possible is to minimize the length of pedestrian and bicycle crossings. At this intersection, you can see that the cyclists traveling along the top of the T intersection actually have nothing to do with the traffic signal at all. It's simply a bicycle path, and pedestrians who want to cross the street first cross the bicycle path to get to the pedestrian button to request the traffic signal to cross the lanes of motor traffic. On the opposite side of the intersection, you can see that the bicycle path also bypasses the area where pedestrians are crossing, which means that the two bicycle path crossings on perpendicular sides of the intersections actually don't conflict with each other, and it becomes possible to have green at the same time. In most cases, these characteristics could be implemented within existing regulations, but in some cases, some regulations would need to be changed in order to permit Dutch-style signal operations to be used in certain jurisdictions in North America. Thanks for watching. I hope you've learned something interesting about the characteristics of Dutch traffic signal design. If you'd like to learn more, stay tuned on our YouTube channel, and we'll have other videos coming up about Dutch traffic signal operations, among other interesting topics.